Hi guys, how are you? So today I wanted to do a video for you on my waterproof makeup. I have been going to the pool for swimming lessons with my baby twice a week for almost a month, or actually a month now. And I have been loving, absolutely loving this makeup that I'm doing. I think it has to do the longevity of it, the water resistant part of it, has and the full coverage obviously has to do with the foundation, but mostly it has to do first with the amount of powder that I'm applying on my face. I think that really makes a difference. Second of all, I'm trying a technique by Wayne Goss that you guys are going to see in the video, and I will try to link the video below. I think that really makes a difference, not only in the day-to-day, but when we are applying this waterproof kind of makeup, and also like full coverage. The next thing that I think really makes a difference is the Lock It Tattoo by Kat Von D that you guys are going to see me applying at the end of the video. It's just really, I feel like it makes a difference. And so anyway, I will leave you with the video. I hope you guys like it. I hope you guys enjoy it. I hope you get some information out of it. And I really, really do hope it works for you, okay? Let me know what you think. Comment below. And I will see you in my next video, okay? Bye. Okay guys, so this is a technique that I was telling you about with Wayne Goss, and he actually talked about applying powder before your foundation, before your cream foundation. And what this is gonna do is that it's really gonna allow those pigments to kind of stick together. It's also gonna give you a little bit more coverage depending on the kind of powder that you use. Right now I'm using the Laura Mercier Brighten and Balance in color medium, and as you can see, it's not a perfect shade for me, so I think it's fine using it now. Next, I'm going on with my concealer. Obviously, this is a step that we all should make, and then I'm wetting my sponge, my Real Technique sponge, with some Fix Plus, and I have found that this technique really, really, really allows that under eye concealer to be blended and to just look the best without looking cakey or powdery or just heavy on your eyelids. This concealer, unfortunately for me, was not that pigmented. I really didn't like the color payoff that I got from it, so I reapplied. Right now I'm going with my foundations, and I'm actually mixing two of them. I'm using the Revlon Colorstay in color 310, and the BB cream from Garnier, the oily combination one, in medium deep. So as you can see, these blend so well into the skin. They give such a good coverage. And I think the Garnier BB cream really allows the Colorstay foundation to get a little bit deeper and also a little bit more yellow, which I feel like there still isn't a Colorstay foundation that really is that yellow tone. It's still a little bit neutral for me, but I feel like if I blend it into my skin, and it also oxidizes a little bit on me, so I feel like at the end of the day it really just looks the same. This light really isn't doing it justice in terms of skin color matching. I'm going in a little bit more for a little bit more coverage. You guys have to excuse my dry skin around the mouth and around the nose, but I'm using my benzoyl peroxide all over the face now, and it just really makes it dry. Right now I'm actually using my Revlon color correcting dark spot concealer. I love this stuff. It is so yellow undertone, so it is very color correcting, plus it's extremely pigmented, plus it's extremely creamy, so it lasts for such a long time. This is the blush in the color Heather from the La Femme Rouge Blush collection. This stuff is amazing. I'm using the complexion brush from e.l.f. And right now I'm actually gonna contour. I haven't contoured in such a long time, but I'm using my e.l.f. small stipple brush, and I'm also using my Wet n Wild Color Icon bronzer. I can't remember the name. I will list it down below. And I'm just using that to kind of frame my face a little bit. Finally, I'm going over it with my powder. And this is actually the Milani Multitasker powder. This stuff is extremely pigmented. This is one of the reasons why I love it so much. Plus, it is very yellow undertone, so it really helps balance everything out and give that little bit of yellow undertone that I'm always looking in my skin.
looking for in my skin. Right now I'm using this product from MAC. It's actually a mineralized skin finish, and it is in the color, I can't remember, sorry, I'm gonna list it down below, but I love this stuff. I've had it for ages. As you can see, I've already hit major pan. I just can't get myself to buy it again, but this stuff is amazing. I whip it out every summer. It's just beautiful and bronzy and goldy and orangey. It's awesomeness. Right now I'm going in for my mascara, and I'm actually using it using the L'Oreal Butterfly Mascara, which is one of my favorites of June. I have been wearing it non-stop. It is so good. You guys are just gonna see immediately the kinds of difference that it makes on my eyelashes. It is almost instant. It gives such good length, and I just love this product so much. I have been enjoying it so much all this month of June. Can you guys see that? It's so amazing. So yeah, it's taking a while. Mascara is probably one of those the times during my makeup session that it just takes a long time. This is the brow pencil from the Ipsy bag from the brand Ofra. I am loving it so much. I feel like it is such a good tone for my skin, and it is such a good texture. It's a very creamy, but it's also not too, it doesn't melt too fast on your skin, and I feel like I just love it. I have been using it nonstop. There it is, guys. Right now I'm going with my Chela clear gel for my brows that also came in an Ipsy bag. And finally, this is the other product that I was mentioning. It's actually not the Lock It Tattoo, but the Lock and Load makeup setting spray from Kat Von D. This stuff is so good. I am definitely repurchasing it. It is awesome. So yeah, guys, that's it. These are the photos from right after I got out of the pool. As you can see, my makeup is so still on, even my blush, even my contour. It is so amazing.
Hey guys, how are you? So right now I just wanted to show you what my kind of skin looks like. I wanted to give you a little update. I'm gonna still put some pictures, but I still wanted to show you what it looks like, okay? So right now I went to the pool. I was there for, I don't know, 30 minutes, 40 minutes, and this is what it looks like. I came out and I ran my errands. Right now I think it's around 4 o'clock in the afternoon, so I've had this makeup already for, I don't know, since like 8 o'clock, so a good amount of hours. And I'm really impressed. I really already know that I love this. So yeah, you guys let me know what you think, okay? Bye.